A very good morning to all of you. I see we are kicking off AIOS by Squin session. So I'm talking about imaging extraocular muscle insertions, and I would be comparing the anterior segment OCT with the ultrasound biomicroscope in this presentation. So we know that precise measurement of extraocular muscle insertion distances preoperatively might be difficult when we have resurgical cases, especially. CT and MRI scans are not reportedly that accurate, and there has been literature which has supported the role of ultrasound biomicroscope as a proven alternative to gold standard caliper measurements. Of late, we have also seen the anterior segment OCT being reported to detect extraocular muscle insertion distances from the limbus. So we did a study to compare the wide field UBM and the swept source OCT, and then compare them with the gold standard caliper for imaging muscle insertion distances only in strabismus reoperations, because we feel that in treatment naive patients, we might not need a UBM or an ASOCT to detect muscle insertions. So it was a prospective comparative case series where we recruited patients aged 6 to 60 years who had a history of strabismus surgery and now wanted an additional strabismus surgeries or required one. Patients who could not have a good ASOCT scan or any conditions which precluded a UBM or an ASOCT like nystagmus or other corneal surface abnormalities were excluded. The muscle insertion distances were measured from the limbus by the ASOCT, and the same patient's same muscle was imaged on the UBM. Both the measurements were done by separate masked observers. The patient comfort was graded on a scale of 1 to 10. And we analyzed both the groups by the intra-class correlation coefficient on SPSS. We had recruited 13 patients with a mean age of 20 years. Most of them were lateral rectus. We had all sorts of diagnoses. We had residual esotropias, exotropias, even one case of DRS. And the mean deviation was around 24 prism diopters. They were all emmetropic patients. We see on the left side that this is how a recessed medial rectus looked on the ASOCT. And on the right side, this is how the recessed medial rectus looked on the UBM scan. Again, a resected lateral rectus on the ASOCT, and on the right, there's a picture of the UBM. So we can see how the cleft between the muscle insertion and the sclera was much clearer on the ASOCT, making the identification of the muscle insertion quite simple and easy. We also saw that once we compared the ASOCT with the caliper reading intraoperatively, as well as the UBM, both of them did not give us much different readings from the caliper reading, but the reading was less than 1 mm by the ASOCT in around 70% cases as compared to the UBM only in 40%. There was an agreement between ASOCT and caliper which was excellent compared to the UBM, which also gave a good correlation. The maximum distance that we could measure on the ASOCT was 14 mm and 10.4 mm on the UBM. Also, in patients who had undergone previous large recessions, we could not localize the muscle by the UBM. The patients also scored the ASOCT better as compared to the UBM. And of course, the time taken to record the non-contact ASOCT was much less than the UBM. We also could identify scars, stress scars, and pseudotendons on the ASOCT. For example, this one. And you can see that this is the scar or the pseudotendon from the previous surgery. And this is where the actual muscle starts on the ASOCT vis-a-vis on the UBM, where the pseudotendon is not very clear. This is the intraop of patient, the picture of the same patient, where you see this is where the original insertion was. This is the previous surgery leading to a stress scar. The hook tells us now the muscle is at this position. This is the medial rectus being imaged. So we use this this technology to treat cases of resurgeries, which helped us in preoperative planning. Here, the patients had undergone a history of Squin surgery. The records were not available. The patient had an esotropia surgery and ultimately landed up with a consecutive exotropia. Here, the medial rectus was imaged and was found to have a stress scar. So we advanced it and got a good outcome because of the ASOCT. Further on ASOCT, sometimes very thin fibrotic muscles can also be identified, which might be difficult to identify on the UBM. Large distances around 13 mm on the ASOCT are easily measured, and on the UBM, sometimes you cannot localize these muscles. So asociity measurements in our paper were more accurate, more posterior, and it was obviously graded as more comfortable by the patient. So it was the first study comparing the asociity and UBM, and the swept soas could transit to delineate the muscle insertion very accurately. They were more comfortable, and in larger recessions, the wide field UBM was suboptimal. This paper is already accepted for publication in JAPOS, and I would like to acknowledge Dr. Jaspreet for this paper. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Savdeen, for an excellent presentation.
Thank you, sir.
I would like to ask one or two questions. One thing is, sample size is quite small.
Yes,
so I think you must continue this excellent study further so that we can get large sample size, and that will be more authenticated.
Yes, sir. It was just a pilot of 13 patients.
Yeah.
We are still continuing because they were all resurgeries. So resurgeries on the same eye also done very less. We have patients who often do not give consent, you know, to get operate the good eye.
Yours is an advanced center where a lot of resurgery patients might be coming.
Yes, sir. We'll definitely continue. Thank you so much.
And secondly, if somebody asks from you that you have to recommend one investigation, so will you recommend asociity or UBM, and in which cases you will recommend asociity, and from your study in which cases you will recommend UBM, and what is the role of dynamic MRI in these sort of patients?
Thank you for that excellent question. Sir, asociity definitely, if it is available, over UBM. I would say in more than 99% cases, I would first image on the asociity. It's hardly 1 in 100 that I would, you know, not be able to image on the asociity and then take the patient for UBM. UBM, I would, do it for patients who are really uncooperative on asociity. If I'm taking them for surgery and I'm giving them general anesthesia, only that case I would do a UBM. Otherwise, for very young children also, it is a very quick technique. It just takes 3 or 4 seconds. So asociity can be tried in the OPD. It's non-touch, so it's obviously better than the UBM. Of course, the accuracy is much, much more, and the localization of the muscle, because it's very clear. And dynamic MRI, sir, is very good technology to locate slipped muscles, lost muscles, and I think all kind of muscle contractile abnormalities. But the dynamic MRI does not give the insertion very accurately from the limbus, and I think that is the most important deciding factor for a surgical dose determination. So for insertion distances, I would prefer an asociity and not.
What is the difference in the cost of the two procedures, Sabine?
The asociity machine, if you are in a tertiary center, would cost you around say 20-25 lakhs, and the UBM, the latest one, also costs approximately the same. So cost.
So what cost to the patient? In a private setup, government, I can't say, but in a private, what would be the cost?
I think it would be the same as you charge for an ultrasound, maybe. So an ultrasound and the UBM are primarily the same machine and just a different probe.
And isn't the MRI more better for this compartmental contraction of extraocular muscle visualization?
Yes, ma'am. For contraction, definitely. For any contractile problem that we are looking at, MRI would be better, because ASOCT and UBM, although they are real time, they will never detect the contractile property of the muscle. They will just tell us this is where the muscle is and this is how it looks. And that also a very small area from the limbus. So we cannot go back. Actually, we might be measuring only the tendon. We might not be actually looking at the muscle also. So it is just for an insertion distance, not at all for contractile property.
Yeah, that's right. Great. As always.
Sorry to interrupt you, doctors. Can we move to our next speaker, please?
Yeah.